Hey everyone, Draco Magnius here for my newest Let's Play of Kingdom Hearts Reply to Chain of Memories. This game, I forget exactly when it was released because I myself found it in a GameStop randomly one year and I decided to get it. It's Chain of Memories was originally created for the Game Boy Advance, but this was made for the PS2, and as such, it looks like a game made for the PS2. But let's get started. As you can see, you can play as Sora or Riku. I've already beaten this game, so I get the choice to pick Riku. However, when you first start this game, you only get to play as Sora. So, if you want to play as Riku, you're gonna have to unlock him by completing Sora's storyline. I'm gonna go with standard mode. I can make do. I have a wireless PlayStation 2 controller, so I don't see how vibration settings are relevant here. I'll keep them on anyway, though. Stereo. Yes, that's good. Make with the story. I'm gonna shut up for the story part, by the way. I might commentate every once in a while, but we'll see. Okay, something I want to bring up now. In that cutscene you just saw, remember in Hollow Bastion where that guy in the robe shot lightning at Sora like he was a Sith from Star Wars? When the hell did that happen? You saw my Let's Play of Kingdom Hearts 1, if you did, of course I'm assuming you did. And if you haven't, I assume you shut this video off and start watching it now. Because a lot of stuff is going to be confusing if you don't watch it. But I don't recall a guy with a black hood shooting lightning at Sora ever. Could that have been in the final mix of Kingdom Hearts 1? I'd assume so, otherwise they just threw that in there to look cool. But I digress. It is nighttime and our heroes are snoozing all except for Sora after the end of Kingdom Hearts 1. And Sora, waking up, or I guess after having a bad dream, decided to go for a little walk. What? Who said that? Am I still dreaming? Hello, creepy, dark-hooded man.
In order to claim it, you must lose something that is dear to you.
Huh? Huh? I don't know if we can trust this guy, guys. I mean, I make it a habit not to trust creepy guys in black hoods that appear to me in the dead of night. Certainly isn't. Was this what's at the end of the path of that meadow? What the hell? As you can, of course, clearly see, this leaves off right after Kingdom Hearts 1 ends, so... And there's the game title again. Hi, game title! Now, a lot of people don't like this game because of the battle mechanic, and you'll see why when we actually get into battling. But for now, let's enjoy more cutscene. And silent talking. Any minute now. There we go. Well, this place sure is white. Jeez, who the hell was the interior decorator here?
Hey, you think it's okay to barge in?
Why not?
The king? King Mickey's here?
Something just told me he'd be here, okay?
Really? Cause now that you mention it, I was kinda thinking the same thing.
Seriously? Me too. One look at this castle, and I just knew.
Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do.
They're here.
Yes, great minds think alike.
Great minds?
Hold on. It can't be just a coincidence.
I know, Timothy. You don't mean that.
Yep, I had it too. Mm-hmm. I had the exact same feeling.
Okay, I reiterate. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do.
Maybe it's contagious.
Well, something's screwy. We better go take a look.
All right.
All right, then, let's get moving.
In?
That way, to the door. Are you scared?
I don't be ridiculous. Come on, let's go, Dizzy.
Hey, fellers, shouldn't we shut the door behind us before we go?
Don't worry.
Sora!
It's an automatic. Or the man in the black robe did it. Or both!
That's it. Who are you?
He's creepy guy in robe. Everyone knows creepy guy in robe.
I was a lot of pressure magic. Flipper! Come on. Flipper! Flipper!
I should think it's obvious. The moment you set foot in this castle, you forgot every spell and every ability you ever knew. In this place, to find is to lose, and to lose is to find. That is the way in Castle Oblivion.
Sounds ridiculous.
Castle Oblivion?
I mean, what if you just live in this castle and you want to go to the next floor and then, oh crap, where the hell did my keys go? Damn it, now I have to go back and get my keys.
You've known in the past, and you will meet people you miss.
Okay.
I miss? Riku! You mean Riku's here?
If what you want is to find him.
Look out, he attacked you with rose petals in darkness. That's so threatening. Damn flowery rose petal man.
What'd you do?
Witchcraft.
I merely sampled your memories, and from them, I made this.
Oh my god, it's a card. Looks like we're gonna play Yu-Gi-Oh! Or Magic, I'm not sure which.
With those you hold dear.
What's this? A card?
It is a
I believe I speak for him when I say,
duh! Hold the card to open the door, and beyond it a new world.
You don't say, Mr. Flowers.
Proceed, Sora.
Or should I call him Mr. Rose Petals?
To lose and claim anew. Or, to claim anew, only to lose.
Sounds so very confusing.
Come on, let's go.
Yes, let us trust the creepy flowery rose petal man in the dark hood, who speaks in riddles like the Cheshire Cat. We obtain Traverse Town. Okay, so that's pretty much the lowdown of what's going on in here. Wow. It's already been 11 minutes, and majority of this was cutscene. Alright, so, this is how every floor of this castle's gonna start. Obviously, to choose between your cards, use the analog stick, you press, stick, you press X to confirm, and that's about all that's here. But since we only have one card, we can only pick Traverse Town. I play the field spell card! Traverse Town! Prepare for crap loads of Yu-Gi-Oh! References, by the way. Because I'm going to use them oh so maliciously. Well, not maliciously, oh so gratuitously? A lot. I'm using them a lot. This can't be right. We're in Traverse Town! What do you mean, we're in Traverse Town, Sora? Two people are missing. What you see isn't real. By the way, I'm doing his voice like that because he's incredibly flamboyant. And you also see his face because we will be seeing his face eventually. You'll see, he is very flamboyant. This town is an illusion created by your memories ingrained in that card. My memories? Forget about that, Sora! We lost Donald and Goofy! Donald? Goofy? Guys, where are you? What did you do with them?
They're at the mercy of the cards now. Master the cards, and their strength will be yours again.
Battle time. Now we get to learn the battle mechanic. This is why everyone who hates this game hates this game. But I think it's not a good enough reason to hate this, but let's go on with the story.
The laws of this castle require that your friends be transformed into cards.
Oh, excuse me.
If you value your friends, you won't fail to pick them up.
During a battle, you'll see Donald and Goofy cards going around. Left analog stick to move, right to look around. Press the right analog stick to center.
The cards you pick up are added to the top of your stack. Use them and your friends will come to your aid.
Okay. X to use a card. Donald will use magic, attack the enemy. Very simple.
The cards you use vanish, but they will reappear to aid you time and again. Cards are the hearts of your friends. Everything in this castle is ruled by cards.
Again, this sounds like a very annoying castle to walk around in if you just... What if someone has to go to the bathroom? Come on. Seriously. Oh, damn it. Need to friggin' get the key for the damn card. That's technically a spoiler, by the way, because doors also run on cards in this crazy, messed up castle.
Whether an enemy or a door confronts you, cards are the only way to proceed, as he just said. You mustn't forget your own strength.
jump with circle, dodge roll with B, thank God, with square, not B. What the hell am I talking about?
First, think for yourself. Move, then use cards.
Okay. Now, he wants us to attack him, but I'm going to explain some things about this. Not a lot of people like this game because of the card mechanic, but I actually enjoy it. It requires another level of strategy because you need to construct your own deck eventually when you get the option. And it's just, you know, it's a nice, refreshing change. I mean, it is a little more complicated, but don't let the card system stop because this game has an excellent story. You press X to use a card, and as you can see, we only have Kingdom Key cards right now.
You know how to use your strength, but it would be of no use if you lose sight of your opponent. I wonder if you can catch me.
R2 to target. And then you just hit it, then release, and that'll get a go.
Good. Every move you make causes a card to disappear. If you use up all your cards, you'll be unable to act. But there's a solution. Keep using cards until you run out, and I'll show you.
Okay.
Die! 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 How many more cards?
Oh, three more. Oh no, all out of cards.
You have no more cards, and without them, no power. If you want that power back, you must focus. Bid the cards to return and to you, and they will.
Okay, reloading cards. Quickly select reloaded cards with the plus button and hold to reload your cards. Observe. Haha!
The strength of your heart brought back the lost cards. You can recall spent cards at any time you need, and time you need only wish it. But each time you do, the cards will take longer to return. The cards are by no means unlimited. Use them wisely.
Okay, as you brought up, you'll see if you look at the corner of the screen that the recharge card, which was the one that we used to call them all back, is now in 2. The highest that number can go is 3, and it'll take 3 seconds of 3 times of holding the button down to fill up. I'd say seconds, but I don't think seconds is the accurate amount of time that it is.
Anticipate the flow of battle, and choose the most effective cards. You may use any card in your deck.
Okay, you cycle through your cards with the left and the left and right buttons, number 1. Very simple.
The 4 card types you use in battle are grouped into 2 wider categories. First categories include attack cards, magic cards, and item cards. The second category consists entirely of enemy cards. To use a card from a different category,
hit the select button. Right now we only have the shadow. And I don't think that's actually in our deck when we continue. We'll have to look in an actual battle.
Cards will empower you whether you're attacking or defending. But it's up to you to decide when to attack and when to defend. Do not forget that.
Load, please. Thank you. And they randomly reappeared in new clothes. Well, they're old clothes, technically. Are you two alright? Where have you been? You tell us. When you opened the door, we saw a strange light. And the rest is just blank. Gee, that doesn't help. What I don't get is if everyone's turned to cards, why not Jiminy? I mean, the rest of them were. Try to remember what happened. I have to keep my journal up to date.
Hey, Donald! Where did I get the new clothes?
Whack! Me too, Goofy! As you all know, if you've seen my Kingdom Hearts Let's Play, I suck at Donald's voice, so we're not doing that. Somebody's been messing with our clothes! Look, clothes. Could it be the cards again?
That's for you to ponder. Master the cards and make your way through the castle, but from here, you walk alone.
Alone? We can't let Sora go alone!
Yeah, Sora can't do anything without our help. Thanks a lot, Donald.
You sure you'll be okay?
Of course. You want me to go alone? Fine, I can take care of myself.
The hero speaks boldly. Go then, the rest of Castle Oblivion awaits. Walk the avenues of latent memory, and you shall meet someone dear to you.
I've got a bad feeling about this. Relax, Jiminy. I'm ready for any tricks he's got up his sleeve. How hard can it be to figure out these cards? All I have to do is use one in front of that door over there. Obtain the Key of Beginnings. The Key of Beginnings is a very special card. It unlocks story in this particular map of the area. Well, in this particular area on the map. Traverse Town. You can perform the following actions in the field. Left analog stick to move, right analog stick to look around, R3 button to face forward. Swing the keyblade with X, jump with circle, and hit B to dodge roll. Not B. Why do I keep saying B? It's square. More tutorial. Sorry guys, this episode is probably going to be all tutorial and some story. Striking objects in the field with your keyblade yields various results. Try striking the barrel. You got it, mysterious voice in my head that isn't the Watcher for a change. You cannot lock onto anything outside of battle, so just hit that. Ooh! Card. Where'd it go? Yes! Got our first magic card, Blizzard number 5. Marked objects can be lifted and thrown. Approach and press the triangle to lift. You got it again, mysterious voice in my head. Oh my god, it's a Heartless! Touching a Heartless on the field starts a battle, but you can strike the Heartless first to gain the upper hand. Throw with X or triangle. Did that work? Yes, it did! Now he's stunned. As you can tell by the little sparkles that are around his head. That means he's going to be stunned for the majority of this battle. Or not the majority of this battle, just the beginning of the battle, I should say. These little gems you're seeing all over the place are experience gems. And now we summon Goofy. He does Whirligoof there. And we just got a map card. Tranquil Darkness. We're going to get into map cards really soon. To open doors in the field, press triangle on the front in front of the door. Before we do that, however, I want to show you some other stuff. Hit random things in the field and they will yield either heal balls like this or other things in some other locations. The red balls are Moogle points. We'll get more into that when they become relevant, because as of right now, they are not yet relevant. So while you're walking around the field, always hit things to collect Moogle points and HP. If you're low in HP after a battle, hit a lantern, or any other thing that could be in the field at the current moment in time. If it's in the field, odds are you can hit it for either Moogle points or HP. There we go. And that takes care of that. But with all that, I think we're going to end this episode here. So the next episode of Let's Play Kingdom Hearts Chain of Memories, we're going to progress through Traverse Town. Well, it would technically be Castle Oblivion Traverse Town, but to cut in time, Traverse Town. And hopefully finish with these tutorials before too much happens. See you guys then.